So there is a way to get ChatGPT as an add-on in Excel. So let's go over how to do that. So you want to go over from your homepage into add-ins. And if you do not have add-ins on your homepage, you're going to want to right-click anywhere, customize the ribbon, home, make sure add-ins are available on your home tab. And if not, you'll be able to find them over here and insert them. So after you have add-ins, you're going to want to go to ChatGPT, it's a new Office add-in. So you'll be able to scroll through and find it, or get add-ins and then look it up. So once you have the add-in, you'll click on it. It will ask to connect to your Microsoft account, which you can allow it. So here's a quick example. You can write a tagline and it will create a prompt. So we can hit try this example. So write a tagline for a bookshop. It comes back with where words come alive and stories find their home. So that's a good tagline and it will auto generate that. So a couple cool features with this. So if you type equal GPT, there will now be a bunch of different functions here. So we can start with something like a table, and this is an interesting one. So the prompt, you'll need to put in quotations. But for this prompt, we can say, what are the leading causes of death in the United States? So this would be if you're doing research in Excel, instead of, you know, looking this up online. If you type this, it will come back with the leading causes of death in the US, heart disease, cancer, accidents, stroke, Alzheimer's, and come back with a list. And so now another cool feature to use with ChatGPT in Excel, and you know, something I could see people actually wanting to get out of it, will be translate. So the text to translate will be here. And you put a comma, target language, put Spanish, put that in quotes. And actually what we're going to want to do is change this from just that. And then you can just copy it down. And there you go. And instead of Spanish, we could put German. So if we copy this down, so that's a quick way to easily change the language of your Excel file. And so now just to cover quickly a couple more functions of GPT in Excel. So if you type equal GPT again and go down to list, this will be similar to the table function. You'll just put in a prompt. We could do, came back with the random one. We could do, what are the most popular tourist attractions? So now it's bringing back tourist attractions. So it's very similar to table, but it will give you a list of the top tourist attractions. So that is another use. And back to the tagline, you can also create a longer tagline, kind of like how you'd prompt ChatGPT in, you know, the OpenAI website. We can just type equal GPT and then parentheses the prompt. We could do write a 300 word story about Harry Potter. And so this will come back. And this came back in a short period of time. So if we wrap text, we can see that there is a 300 page story about Harry Potter. And so these are some of the most useful things for Excel and ChatGPT within it with the add-in. There is a pricing. So a free trial gives you 10 cents, which gives you a decent bit of prompts. But if you're using this all the time, you can buy packs for like $19 or $45, which will last you quite a bit of time, but it does cost money for input and output. So, you know, only use it whenever you really want to get a prompt back quick or create a list, it will save you a ton of time. But that's all I have for you in today's video. If you enjoyed it, remember to subscribe and hit that like button. And thanks for watching.